Now we're making the tail, and we're going to use the bigger hook for this one, the 4.5 millimeter. And when you're done, we also need the steel pet brush. So we start at the tip of the tail, and we work our way down to the bottom of the tail. And row one is a loop of 6 stitches, and like I showed you when we did the body and the head, I used the magic ring method, so I'm going to go over very quickly. And if you need further help with that, you can, again, hit one of the links in the description box below. So I take this shorter yarn tail and I wrap it around these two fingers twice. And then hold the yarn tail between my pinky and my thumb, and the working yarn in between my pinky and my thumb. Then I go through, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through. And there was my slip knot. Now I put 6 stitches into this loop. And when I go through, I'm going through both yarn strings. Right through the center, grab me my yarn and pulling it through. Yarn over and pull through. And there was one single crochet, and I'm going to do that 5 more times. There's 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And now we need to close up this loop. I'm just going to pull that yarn tail out of the way. Remember, I hang on to this part here. And I pull on one of these strings to close up the loop. So that first one didn't work. I'll try the second one. And of course that one works. And then I have to get rid of this loop, so I'm going to pull on the yarn tail. And there is my loop with 6 stitches. Row 2 is 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet in the second stitch, and then 2 single crochets into the third. Then we repeat that one more time. 1, 1, 2. Remember when you go through that you're going through both loops of your stitch. So we'll just do this row together. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet in the second, and now 2 single crochets into that third stitch. 1 and 2. Now I'm going to repeat that one more time. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet into the second, and 2 single crochets into the third. And remember, if I'm going too fast, that you pause me, and when you're ready to carry on, then you can start the video again. So we finished row 2, now we have 8 stitches around, and it's starting to fold up on itself, so we're just going to turn it right side. Where the starting yarn tail is coming out of, push that inward. That's the tip of the tail. You can add a stitch marker if you'd like, but I'm just going to count out in my head. Row 3 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 8 stitches. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And there's the end of row 3. I can add a stitch marker now. Go into that last stitch I just put in and pull the marker through. Row 4 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches and then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. And we repeat that one more time. When we land on the marker, we'll be putting in 2 single crochets. So one in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. 1 and 2. Now we're going to repeat that one more time. 1 single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, 2 is going to land on the marker, and 2 single crochets into that last stitch of the row. We finished row 4, and now we have 10 stitches around. Move our marker again. Row 5 is 1 single crochet in the next 4 stitches, and then 2 single crochets into the 5th. Then you repeat that one more time. There was 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 2 into that 5th. And now we're going to repeat that sequence. One single crochet in the next four. That's one, two, three, and four. Two single crochets into the fifth. One and two. Move the marker. That's the end of row five, and now we have 12 stitches around. Rows 6 and 7 is one single crochet at each one of those 12 stitches for two rows. So I'll continue off the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we at the end of row 7. Just remember to move your marker at the end of this row. One single crochet in each one of those 12 stitches for two rows. I'll continue off the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 7. Alright, I'm at the end of row 7 and I've moved my marker. Row 8 is one single crochet in the next two stitches. Then we crochet two stitches together, and then we're going to repeat that all the way around. So one in the first, one in the second, and now two stitches together. Now repeat that sequence, and the next two, then two together. Repeating for the last time, one in the next two. Two together is going to land on that marker, so I'll pull it out. And that's the end of row 8, and now we have 9 stitches around. I'll move my marker. Rows 9 and 10 is one single crochet in each one of those 9 stitches for 2 rows. So I'll continue on to pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 10. One single crochet in each one of those 9 stitches for 2 rows. Okay, I'll finish row 10. And our tail is done. We can just slip stitch into the next stitch and finish off. So just go through, grab your yarn. Instead of yarning over, just pull the first loop through the second loop. Finish off leaving a bit of a tail for sewing. Pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. We don't stuff the tail, but if you have a steel pet brush handy, then you brush out the tail. I think it looks really cute when it's all brushed out. If you don't have one of these, I've been told that Velcro can work, probably take a lot longer, or a hard bristled nail brush. This is the ideal thing to have when you're brushing out yarn, and you just keep it moving. As you're brushing, keep it moving. Don't stay in one spot or you could potentially put a hole in the piece. So just brush it out and keep moving all the way around and get it as fluffy as you can. Quite a bit. That didn't take very long with that little steel pet brush, and that's going to look very cute once it's on our little squirrel. Now we're going to make the limbs, and you make 4 of these, and they're all exactly the same. When you're done, you'll have 4 pieces like this, and we're using our bigger hook, the 4.5 millimeter hook, and we chain 8. So yarn over and pull through 8 times. And 8. There's our chain of 8. Now starting in the second chain from the hook, there's the first one. We're starting in the second one. We're going to put a single crochet in each one of those chains. When I go through, I like to make sure there's 2 loops of that chain on top of my hook and 1 loop of that chain on the bottom. Yarn over and pull through, and now hold on to this piece down here underneath your crochet hook. Yarn over and pull through those 2 loops. And there's a single crochet in the second chain from the hook. Now we're going to go into the next chain. The one we just worked will have a bigger loop. And there's 2. Three. Six, and last one, 7. So there we are done. We can finish off, leave a bit of a tail for sewing, pull that yarn tail through that loop, and pull it tight. And there we should have 7 stitches across. We began with that chain of 8, but because we started in the second chain from the hook, we end up with 7 stitches. And we're going to make 4 of these. I'm going to show you how to sew this together to make it into an arm or a leg. We're just going to fold this chain in half. And then we're going to sew all these outer loops together on both sides. So I just go through 1 outer loop on each side. And then one more time up here. Now I'll bring my yarn needle right through to the other side. And I'm going to sew up the other side now. Now I'm just going to knot this off up here in the corner. So before pulling that all the way through, I'm just going to go through that loop and then pull it tight. And the starting yarn tail, we can get rid of that by burying it inside. So just thread it through your yarn needle and bring it right through the piece and then out through a stitch hole. And now you can cut that free. So you should have 1 longer yarn tail. So we're going to go ahead and make 4 of these. So you need to make 3 more. Okay, now we're going to start sewing this little guy together. So pretty simple to sew the limbs on. You just want to make sure that they're on evenly and on each side of the head, in line with each side of the head. And the legs go on this way. And the arms go on this way, legs this way. And you can sew them on any way you would like to. This little guy here, his arm actually was naturally sitting up like that, so I just left it. I thought it looked kind of cute. He was waving. That's my little treble teddy. So I've already got 1 arm sewn on here, and I got the yarn tail, finishing yarn tail, hanging out the back of the body, and I'll leave it there until I get this one done. So you just place it on. You can pin these in place first and see if you're happy with the placements. Like I said, just make sure that they are even. And I just bring my first stitch in right underneath the neck. And I just come out through a stitch hole anywhere where it feels comfortable to come through. So there's 1. Now I'm going to go back in the same stitch hole I just came out of and come up at the top, just under the neck. And then I'll go back in and I'll grab a bit of that arm, going back in, and then out through a stitch hole anywhere on the body. And that's pretty much sewn in now. It just is going to get a lot of play, and you think the kids would be pulling on the arms. Of course, you want to put a couple more stitches in on the top just to make sure it's nice and in there and it's not going to come out. But for me, that's good right there. That'll do the trick. But if it's flaring out too much, like this one here, and you don't actually want that kind of look, then you can just go back in through the same stitch hole you came out of and come up underneath the arm. And you can go right through the arm. Position the arm the way you want it, and then go back in just a little ways over where you came out. You want to make sure that you're happy with the placement. Then bring the yarn needle out where the other yarn tail is hanging. Just pull on this lightly though, if you go through the arm, because if you pull too tight, it's going to alter the shape of the arm. So just pull it snug enough to hold that arm in place, but not too tight to alter the shape. Now I can knot these 2 off. I will cut them up a bit shorter. You can also thread them both and then carry that knot away, or just push the knot into the body. Okay, now we're going to sew the legs on. Now these have to be positioned right, otherwise your little guy could flop over when it sits down. So pin them on first and make sure that once they're both pinned on and you set it down that it doesn't flop over, because if they're back too far or too ahead too far, it'll flop either way. And if it doesn't stop flopping after you rearrange these legs, it could be that the head, just push the head in a better position. That does make a difference as well. I just got the one leg in, and again brought the yarn tail out through a stitch in the back, and I'll knot it off with this one when I'm done. So just to get the first stitch in, just go right through the back. That's where the yarn tail is coming out of there. And I just go down anywhere where it feels comfortable to bring the yarn needle through. And then pull it through, and again, I'm not pulling anything super tight, just snug enough to hold it in place. And then going back in the same stitch hole I just came out of. And then when I go back in, I'll just grab a bit of that leg, putting my yarn needle right through the leg, and then down into the body. And again, anywhere where it feels comfortable to come through. And now I'll go back in and I'll come up right through the middle of the leg, underneath the body and through the leg. Pull it through. Now I'll just bring my, I'll take those pins out first. Bring that yarn needle just over a little ways from where I came out and then back down into the body. Again, I'm not squeezing anything or pulling anything tight. I'm just letting the yarn needle go where it needs to go. Okay, so once you feel they're on, then you can just knot these two off and then get rid of them like I showed you how to do earlier. So now we'll do the ears, and we're using the bigger crochet hook. And these are crocheted right onto the body, and we're going to add them before we add the tail. So we want to make sure that they're in line with the arms, and I insert my hook in between the second and third row. We count from up here, one, two, and three, in between the second and third row. And I just push my hook through and underneath, just like that. Then I'll get my yarn and I'm going to lay it over the crochet hook, and I'm going to pull it through. Get ready to crochet on. Hang on to that yarn tail in the back so it doesn't pull through. Chain one. And now we'll put three double crochets in the very same space we just pulled the yarn through. A double crochet is a lot like a half double crochet. You have to yarn over before going in. So yarn over and go into that same space. Grab the yarn and pull it through. And now you have three loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through the first two loops. Now you have two loops again. Yarn over and pull through those two loops. And there was one double crochet. We're going to do that two more times. Yarn over, back in the same space we were just in. Pull your yarn through. You have three loops. Yarn over, pull through the first two. Yarn over and pull through the last two. Now one more time. Yarn over, back in the same space. Pull your yarn through, pull yarn over and pull through the first two, yarn over and pull through the last two. And there was three double crochets. Now we're going to slip stitch into the same space we were just in. So go through, pull your yarn through. So now we just pull the first loop through the second loop. Sometimes you have to flip your bear up so you can hang on to it here. And just pull that loop through there. Through the last loop. And now you're done. Now you can finish off. Pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. Now we'll just bring both yarn tails out through the back of the head. So just go through and bring it out through a stitch anywhere. Now I just knot these two off, cut them up a bit shorter, and shove that knot into the back of the head. So now we're ready for the second ear, and it's the same thing. In between the second and third row, 1, 2, and 3. In line with the arms. Lay the yarn over and pull it through. Chain one. So yarn over before going in. You have 3 loops, yarn over, pull through the first 2. Yarn over, pull through the last 2. That was 1, 2, and 3. And now I'm going to slip stitch into that same space. Pull the yarn through. And again, I'm going to have to hang on to this here. Pull the first loop through the second loop. Now I can finish off. Pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. I just want to stretch out that ear, make sure it looks like the other one. That looks pretty good. So now I'll just bring the yarn tails in through the back of the head like I showed you on the first one and cut them away. Okay, in the written pattern, I actually attach the tail before I do the face, but let's do the face first before we attach that awesome little tail. And all I use is yarn. You can use whatever you want. You can use felt, buttons, safety eyes, it doesn't matter, whatever you want to use. I just use yarn. And I outline it a little bit with some white yarn that I split. So I'm going to show you how to do that. These eyes are in between the 5th and 6th row, and there's about 2 or 3 visible stitches in between them. So of course you want to go on either side of this muzzle part here. And what you can do as well is put pins there where you think the eye should go. I was thinking right about there. And then see how that looks to you. So you've marked off the space. And if you think they should go higher, then you put them higher or lower. It's all up to you. It's all personal preference. This is where I'm going to put mine. So what I do is I just go through a stitch hole inside the head and I bring the yarn through. And I'm going to pull one yarn tail through and leave the other one hanging in the back. I'll take that pin out now. And I'm just going to wrap around just grabbing a little bit of a stitch in there. That's pretty much what I want it to look like right there. So I'm going to bring this yarn needle through on the other side so it wraps again. And I'll go through where the other pin is sitting. Pull the pin out. Pull the yarn through and remember not to pull too tight. I think that looks really good right there. So now I'll just do the same thing on this side. Wrap around. Okay, I want to put that other wrap in, so this time I'm going to go on this side here. So it actually wraps twice when I bring this out through where the other one is hanging. And I'll pull on it, don't pull too tight. And if you do pull it too tight, just push your needle in there and pull it back out. So that looks pretty good. Now these, a little bit more difficult to shove into the head without it showing through. Bring your yarn needle into the head a bit and then pull it out through somewhere else. It'll just kind of guide that yarn out of the way. Now I'd pull on it slightly and cut. And then when it springs back in, it's disappeared. Because that's so dark, I like to outline it a little bit with white. And all I do is take a piece of yarn, a strand of yarn, and I'm going to twist it in the opposite direction that it's spun in. And then I can split it. And then I just outline the part I put in, the black part. So I just go in the corner, pull it through, leave one yarn tail in the back hanging, and then go up. So it'll be wrapping around the one corner of the eye. And remember not to pull tightly, just pull very loose. Then I go back in and do the other side. And you can also do around the bottom as well, and the top. You can go all the way around if you want to. So there's some ideas for you anyway to get you started. Okay, now the little nose part. I use embroidery thread. But again, if you don't have any embroidery thread, split some yarn. Also, yarn will work too. I like to have this part a little bit thinner. The fiber is a little bit thinner to work with. So again, going through the side of the face, and I go just below the eyes. So I come up right about there. And then I'm just going to wrap the yarn. And I wrap a number of times. Okay, so when you're happy with the nose, and I just finish it off with a bit of a line. You don't have to do this part again, it's just an idea for you. I'll just pierce the row underneath. I'm coming right through the row, not through a stitch hole. Right through the row. And then I'll bring this right going underneath the nose and piercing the row again and back out. And that's all. I just, again, very simple. And feel free to play around with this part. These are a little bit harder to push into the head, so I'm going to thread both yarn tails and I'll just pull them through. Then I'll pull on them slightly and cut. Now last part, we can put on this awesome tail, and you want the tail to look like this when you sew it on. So of course you just put it on the back and sew in this bottom edge. So now that we have the bottom of the tail stitched in place, we want to stitch up here just to hold it up against the body so it's always standing upright. So I just go through and I just come up, bring my yarn needle right up about there, middle of the back, bring it through. And now I'm going to go through the tail on the inside only. It's not coming on the outside, on the inside of the tail, right through. Pull it through. And then bring the yarn needle into the middle of the back, right about there, and then bring it down somewhere else. And then pull it through. And give it a pull. And there, that's just tacked that tail in place. Now we can just bring this up here. I'm going to knot it off with one of these brown stitches here. Before pulling it all the way, just go through that loop and pull it tight. Now I'll just bring this in and away. Pull on it slightly and cut. So that's the end of this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. And if you did make yourself a little squirrel, please post pictures on my Facebook page, Amigurumi Freely. I'd love to see. Thanks so much for watching, and see you soon!